We're back. Yeah. I just turned the turntable off. It sound like your mom and then breathing backwards.
That's your mom.
Quick, that's like your record. Somebody kick the plug out.
Hey, that's like my girlfriend too.
Shut your mouth.
She was ragging. I kicked the plug out. She messed up her whole skirt.
That's your mom. Your mom ran off back battery. So when she was asleep, I kicked the plug out. So she couldn't go to work because why her body wasn't fully charged. Told you, she ain't like that pink bunny. She like a gray bunny. Keep smoking, and smoking.
Okay, what's up, kid?
Yo. Hey, good to be here, man. I've heard you a few times during the show, and it's slamming, man. We put it together, came down. I heard we had a fat kid set, a kid and play set.
Yes,
for all the old-time hip-hoppers out there, right?
I mean, old.
How old?
He ain't really old, though.
You know what? You know what? The Lord's been kind. I look a lot younger than I actually am.
Yeah, he's a blessing.
Hip-hop's in the heart, man. Don't you know that?
Sure. That's where it starts.
Yeah, that's what they say. But it's kind of funny. Actually, I haven't heard, like, the first one y'all played last night. I haven't heard that in a long time.
Oh, yeah. I was bootlegging some of that last night. So happy.
You look like you were bootlegging a lot of things over the years, homie.
Hey, is my mic on? I can't hear myself.
Test. All right, that's a lot better.
Hey, now tell you told me this story off the air. Maybe everybody out there want to know. Tell me the story about that.
Back in the day when I was a starving DJ, right, at Claire Ham House, we used to live in the 30s, I didn't have enough money to buy two albums, so I went to this record store up in the Crenshaw Swap Meet, and it was either, you know, a Ken Play album or MC Hammer album. So I thought about it. I was like, dang. And we had a party that night, too. And since y'all have more club records on y'all, you know, on y'all album, I bought the Kid and Play record.
And at that moment, that's when your success was destined. Yes, I knew. I felt it. So it was in the
air. Y'all, that's Kid. Y'all got to see him in here, too. He don't have the high top no more. It's like real low. And
yes,
orange.
He do. He said it's cold outside, so he didn't wear it.
Oh.
We got Kermit the Frog in here. And
he said Kermit the Frog.
Nah, I'm doing like the curly afro back to the essence type thing.
Hey, kid, tell me what you're doing now, though, man.
Yeah, I'm getting calls in. It's happening. Actually, doing a lot of different stuff, man. Mostly real television oriented these days. You know, I actually moved out here a couple of years ago to kind of concentrate and focus on that. So
ching,
it's been
ching ching.
You know, it could be some more ching on that ching, but yeah. That's what the process is about. Sometimes it's kind of a process in terms of creating your own vehicles and stuff. And then most recently, I've actually been doing like a lot of stand up comedy around the country stuff, kind of putting together. It's kind of a different thing I put together where I kind of combine the comedy and the music. You know, when I do my stand-up around the country, I actually have my DJ. The DJ was with us back in the days, DJ Wiz.
Yeah.
And it's kind of weird. It's almost like if you've seen, like, comedians that kind of have an accompanist, it's like a keyboard player or a piano player. He's kind of my accompanist and kind of allows me to kind of, you know, I can freestyle off the top about, you know, people in the crowd or whatever. So it just kind of brings a little different element to it. And it's been going real well, man. Actually, I'm getting ready to run around and do a tour of all these improv comedy clubs around the country. And, you know, just trying to...
Around here?
You know, you usually find me down at the Melrose Improv or the Improv down in Irvine or in Brea. I've done a lot of stuff over there. I'm a fax it to you, man.
I'm
gonna go down there. And
he want me to jump over the leg. He want me to jump over my leg and break my leg.
I'm gonna go there and bag on in front of your friends. Okay, we got Kermit the Frog in here.
See that? You want to come and show some love, right?
Yeah. He want to do stand-up, too.
No, I don't
practice.
Well, he's a funny guy now. That Great Bunny, that was a funny joke, man.
That was all freestyle.
Have you ever jumped on stage and just done?
No, man. I ain't nothing funny about me, really.
Well, that's the next step, man. I mean, if you know how much cats was getting around the country for doing that, you'd get up there.
Yeah, I can't leave Cali. Not no more.
Why? How you know Cali don't want you to leave?
Huh?
Cali said, go on, try it, don't worry.
Hey,
you.
Look,
that's Cali.
Hey,
Cali told me that.
If you see Quik Mom, you'll believe you can't leave her now. I came back and she met me at the airport. She looked me in the eyes.
And she said,
Kermit? It's all Kermit out. He loved, that's his favorite song.
You got a special relationship with Quik's mom. What's the deal with that, man?
Yeah, me and him go way back. He's playing my same football team.
Okay.
See, now I'm waiting now.
Yeah, I started hearing some music. But you guys don't understand, I haven't got headphones on. I'm just telling you. No, don't pass me along. I like this.
Yeah. I need an excuse for my dud.
You happy about the Raiders, though, right?
Okay, yeah. Oh, yeah, Raiders, most definitely. I got my boy Cheese up here representing the Dolphins. You got to see this guy now.
He got blood all over his jersey, his Dolphins jersey.
Because he's teething.
He tried to change his shirt before we came up here. He's like, quick, man, you got a shirt?
Not for you. So guess what he did? He took his pants off and put a belt around his jersey. So now he got a merino skirt. How do you like that one, kid?
That was funny. Quik mess around and put a beat to that joint.
Hey, so since the theme of the show, right, we need to call it the Way Too Joke For, Way Too Funny Radio,
or Way Too Effing Real Radio.
Yeah, you know, actually with me, you know, the comedy stuff, as you know, Quik, as you move further along into this business, you don't always end up doing the same thing that you started out doing.
Yeah,
I think
like,
if you're smart.
Like bear-backing. Yeah.
I'm here. A lot of us stop doing that. That's like drinking and driving.
Big shout out to my homeboy Valtrex.
You know what I'm saying? It's like drinking and driving.
And his partner's Overax. Big shout out.
You can't ride no more.
Oh, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Nah, I'm just saying, you don't necessarily end up doing the same thing you start out doing. I mean, hopefully, if you got some other things you can do, you know, in this industry, you kind of have to be as versatile as you can to keep doing different things. And I've been lucky, you've been lucky as well, doing different things. And you know, with myself, this comedy thing. But last year was your big break. I've been lucky to do a lot of different things.
That was a fly show, too.
Yeah, that was. Hey, you know what? I had a blast doing that. I got to work with Dick Clark, who recently celebrated his 137th birthday.
Wow!
Yeah,
and still got dark hair. Dick is fly, right? Well, Dick Clark is fly.
No. Let me clear that up. Rogaine is fly. Time advertised right there.
Now, but you know how it is. You get to expand and work with different folks, but at the same time, it honestly is real cool to come back in this flow. And you know, this is the first love, the music, and everything like that. So you know. I appreciate being down here with y'all.
Exactly. And
the funny man.
Thank you, dog.
The funny man.
Hey, we in the house with you, homie. I mean, we look up to you, man. I grew up to you watching y'all on BET way back when BET used to only play videos. Now they play infomercials.
Oh, man. You
know? Oh, right? Speaking of that, on New Year's, what part of the game is this? BET. New Year's Eve, all the things they could have played, it could have been a celebration going on. You turn it on 1 minute before New Year's, and you see Ron Popeil selling the rotisserie oven on BET on New Year's, the first year of the new millennium officially.
Yeah,
that's gangster, man. That white boy.
I don't know what that is. I mean, you know what? The thing is, we all love BET. We all grew up watching it. But I think sometimes we get a little disappointed because we see it. We see what it could be. You know, we're gonna watch it because we don't really have too much of a choice. But you know, just little stuff like how come every time you turn to BET, you got to boost the sound up? You know, you ever go from MTV to BET? You always got to boost the sound up. Like little stuff like that.
You got
man.
A separate app for BET.
Yeah, every time I see BET, I see Cleo. You know, that's all I see with the fake Jamaican accent.
Wow.
Everybody in your business.
Hey, call me.
Call me in my fake accent. Come on.
Hey, it's funny. She be calling your house too now. She be on them little. No, for real. It'd come up. The number come up all zeros. It's like some Satan worship.
Look, my dad's Jamaican, and all I know is my dad wants to. He wants to hit Cleo. He wants to.
Not bareback.
I don't know. Well, he's shooting. He probably shoot. He's like 72 now, so he ain't worried about it. You know what I'm saying?
Wow. Well, since we're speaking of folks, y'all, this is only here on the Way Too Funky Radio Show.
Talking nasty to a beat.
Man.
And blazing.
It's real life. But speaking of folks, since this is folk, can we play my daddy, man, the Godfather of Soul, man? We're going to get this ready because I guess this man really started folk.
Yeah.
You know, Boosie used to play for his band, you know, way back in the day, him and Phelps, his brother, when they was young, growing up. I mean, when you think of funk, you got to think of James Brown. I mean, he was even before George Clinton and all of them, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, no question about it. I mean, it's amazing. I mean, as a matter of fact, now, off the topic, just a little second, I saw something on television the other day about this blues cat named Robert Johnson. I mean, sometimes you don't realize how the roots go so deep, you know what I mean? And stuff that folks have created that we build on to this day. I mean, it's amazing. And when you think about it, we get to do our thing now, and that's great, but these people created it for nothing, man. And that's like,
exactly.
that's what's amazing.
That's real that you mentioned roots going deep, because Mike Mama here, he grow like inside tickle her brain.
Or like Quik's mom, athlete feet. It burns so bad, it's all to the root.
Absolutely. I love to burn to the root.
Use Micotin. You won't burn again.
Leave me alone, y'all. Check this out, y'all. This is Mr. James Brown. We're going to bang this, dog. Number seven is T.O. James Brown, this is your love, y'all. So only you can only hear it here, y'all. DJ Quik, W2FR, Power 106, Kid in here having a
Mike BZ.
Doing our thing, y'all. Power 106.
Get at us.
out of here. I think